In this problem, we're going to investigate what happens when you connect a block to two springs, not just one. And unlike in the shock absorber's problem, we're going to connect these springs to each other, not both directly to the block. This is what we call putting springs in series, rather than in parallel like we did with the shock absorbers. It turns out we can view a block dangled from two springs in this configuration as exactly the same as a single spring there with a different spring constant. So in other words, if I covered up the springs and you just watched the block oscillating up and down, you wouldn't actually be able to tell the difference between these two cases, the case where there are two springs connected and the case where there's just one. So for these two scenarios to be exactly equivalent, there actually has to be a very special relationship between the spring constant K3 and the spring constants K1 and K2. And that's what I want you to solve for in this problem. So I want you to tell me, what's the value of K3 in terms of K1 and K2 such that these two scenarios produce exactly the same behavior? And in each of these black boxes here, you can put either plus, minus, or times. Good luck.